Jamie Madison here. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today we're going to be using the Simon Says Stamp March card kit. This card kit is called Amazing, and it's a 6x8 stamp set, so it's a very large stamp set. So with this stamp set, you're going to get some very supportive phrases like, so very proud of you, and I totally get you. Everyone agreed. You're doing a fantastic job. So the one we're using today is so very proud of you. So I just really like these. I like how you can send it to someone who has been going through a lot, or you know that they've been really trying hard at something and you just want to say, hey, I see you. I recognize you. I want to send this to you because I think you're great. So to get started, we're going to be doing my Fisker silicone mat because we're going to be doing ink blending here, which I've already got started. So what I'm using is my Bristol Smooth. This is cut to 4¾ by 5½, but we're going to be cutting it down at the end anyways. The Distress ink that I'm using to do this, I started with a 3-pair set, but then end up using a fourth one at the very end. So I'm going to put the list of the Distress inks I'm using in the left-hand corner here of the screen. So to start, it's Peeled Paint, Lucky Clover, and Pine Needles. And then the very end, we use some Mode Lawn to just blend it through. Now, when you're using Bristol Smooth, the reason I use it is because your sponge does not grab onto the paper, so it gives you a little bit more time to blend. Now, it also takes a little bit more time to dry, so just make sure if you're going to be doing some heat embossing like I'm going to be doing on this card, you give it plenty of time to dry, and you also use a anti-static bag, or I'm just using a sock with some powder in it. So to get started, I'm going to be using my VersaMark, and I'm using all the solid printed circles in the stamp set. I'm just going to tape it down to my mat so whenever I'm using my acrylic block, it doesn't pop up whenever I pull away. It's a little trick that you can do whenever you're using acrylic block is you want to tape down your piece. That way you can keep going back and forth and you don't have to worry about smudging or smearing. Now, you don't have to use an acrylic block. You can always use a stamp positioner like a Misty or Tim Holtz or whatever you have that you like to use. Now, I just happened to use my acrylic blocks because I had a lot of small pieces and I didn't want to have to constantly move them, change them, and it would just take too long. So I'd rather just use acrylic block for things like this. After I finish stamping all of my little circles, I'm going to go in with my Recollections in Gold. This embossing powder is beautiful and it has such a beautiful shine to it. I'm then going to go in with my heat gun. Make sure you let your heat gun warm up before you add it to your paper. If you go in with a cold heat gun and it's not hot yet, it's going to warp your paper. And that is the last thing you want to do when you've worked so hard on your piece is your paper to be wonky and warpy. So make sure that's nice and hot. Now to add a little bit of abstract to my piece, I went in with some washi tape and I'm just using a circle. Any circle will do. I just happen to have some washi tape sizes on hand. I went in with my micron in 08 for my pen size. Now moving on to my sequins. If you have used the Simon Says Stamp kit for a while, you have seen the Beautiful Mermaids from September's card kit last year, and that is a sequence that I'm going to be using. Ignore the green ones. I end up not going with those. The green just didn't blend very well with the piece that I was doing, so I decided just to stay with the gold. I did go quite a bit of sequence on here, but I do like a lot of shine. So back to the Simon Says Stamp September kit, I'm using the treasure chest sequence. So I went and bought an extra set of these because I absolutely loved them from the September kit, and they went perfect with this. They have such a beautiful shine, and there are multiple sizes in it, which I like as well. Now moving on to the sentiment, I'm going to be using my Simon Says Stamp Vellum, and make sure you use an anti-static powder as well on this because you don't want it to stick, especially on vellum. It shows pretty much any color, so you would want it to be nice and crisp and clean lines. I'm using my stamp positioner. This is the Stamp Perfect from Hampton Arts that I got not too long ago. I absolutely still love it, along with my Tim Holtz. It's kind of like a flip between both of them. I love both of them equally. So I'm going to be stamping on here, so very proud of you. Now, to stamp this, I'm using the Versamark. This is a very sticky ink. You can use any kind of sticky ink that you have. Even Simon Says Stamp has a embossing ink that you can use. I've even used Distress inks to do embossing before as well. You just gotta be quick with it. As long as the ink doesn't dry too quickly, you'd be fine. So I'm using my gold embossing powder that we use to do the circles. Then I'm gonna take my already hot heat tool that I've had on just for a few minutes, and I'm gonna take that straight to the vellum. Like I said, you don't want your heat tool to be cold before you start because it will warp your vellum very quickly, and we don't want our vellum to warp. So after we have that, I'm just going to wipe off that excess powder that I had on there, and then I'm going to trim this down. I don't have exact measurements. I kind of just eyeballed it and trimmed it down to what I thought would look good on this card. I did leave extra hanging off, so whenever I went to wrap it around the card, that I had plenty to work with. Now, a couple of my sequins were in the way, so I just went ahead and removed them, which is fine because I'm going to put a couple sequins on the vellum as well. I'm also going to cut a triangle at the bottom of my vellum. I wanted this to look like a banner. And after I have that triangle cut out, I'm going to wrap this around my card. I'm going to take my ATG tape ruler. So this is just a tape gun. And I'm just going to adhere some tape strips on the back where my vellum is going to be. This way, it gives me a little bit more time to fussy around with the placement of it. And I don't have to worry about fighting the time with the glue. Because if I was using glue, then I'd have to work a little bit quicker because my glue that I normally use is the Tombow and it does dry quite quickly. So the glue I'm going to be using though for the sentiment, this is the Gina K Connect glue. I bought a couple of these because they were quite a big hit when they came out, and I can tell why, because they do absolutely amazing. It's a nice fine tip and it puts detail right where I want it without it squirting everywhere. So it's perfect for doing these kind of sentiments with the vellum. Now I wanted to add just a little bit of extra hold to the sentiment, so I put two little glue dots underneath, but I'm going to cover that up with some of those gold sequins still. I just wanted to give it a little bit of that extra hold. And whenever you're using glue, if it goes on vellum, you will see a dark spot. So if you're going to use glue, make sure you have a way of disguising it or covering it up. Alrighty, so now that we have our sequins down and the front of our card pretty much complete, I'm going to go in with my double-sided foam tape. Just make sure whenever you go in with your tape that the front of your card is dry because you don't want your sequins moving around and smearing glue everywhere. So I went ahead and used 4 pieces of my foam tape. I wanted to make sure that you have good stability behind this. You don't want your card to bend in the middle. I went ahead and took a pre-cut card base. This is the Michaels 110-pound cardstock. I went ahead and scored this for an A2 top folding card. And here are my 2 cards. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you guys so much for joining me. I really appreciate it. And if you would like to enter in to win a $25 gift card to Simon Says Stamp to celebrate me hitting 500 subscribers, just make sure you like this video, you're a subscriber, and comment down below what stamp set you would like to have. Thank you so much for joining me, and you guys have a wonderful rest of your day, and I will see you next week. Bye!